Hi, friends. I'm Pastor Jonathan Perry. And like all of you, I watched with heartbreak the events of the past weeks in our nation's capital, hallowed halls, as the forces of falsehood, conspiracy, white supremacy, force, swelled to violence and to tragedy. It was unbelievable, yet in some way foreseeable. And my utter heartbreak led me to prayer, as I know it did for all of you. In the New Horizons Sunday School class this week, the prayers lifted up were these. Prayers for our nation in the aftermath of the insurrection at the U.S. Capitol building last week. Prayers for those injured and the families of those who lost their lives. Prayers for a peaceful and smooth transition in our government as we approach the presidential inauguration next week. And prayers for a better future ahead. And on the way to church, on Frenchie's orange trucks in big letters, it said, "Pray for peace." And I did. We all do. We pray for peace. Lord, hear our prayers. This week, I've also been reflecting about how we're called to put those prayers into action, to pray with our hearts and pray with our feet. How we, as followers of the way of Jesus in this time, our time, are called to the work of moral courage, of truth and reconciliation, of peace and justice, of faith and hope and love. There's much work to do, but it is our sacred calling. And God is with us and for us and before us. This week, as we remember the legacy of the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., the ongoing work for civil rights, I thought of John Lewis, who marched with King as a student, who led in his Ebenezer Baptist Church, and who served our nation for 6 decades with moral courage. So I thought of him because before the events of January 6th, the last public event in the Capitol Rotunda was the lying in state of Congressman John Lewis. And I like to think that on that day, and even now, his words are reverberating in the rotunda, bearing witness to our better angels. And so on this day, I want to share with you his last words written to us. John Lewis writes this: "I have long believed and I have long preached that our nation's moral compass comes from God. It is of God. It is seen through God. Ours is a sacred struggle. There are forces today in America trying to divide people. There are forces today that are still preaching hate and division. There are forces today who want us to return to the old ways. It makes me sad, for we don't want to go back. We want to go forward and create one community, one America. The journey begins with faith, faith in the dignity and worth of every human being. This is an idea with roots in Scripture and in the canon of America, in Genesis and in the Declaration of Independence. The journey is sustained by the persistence in the pressing of the justice of the cause. And the journey is informed by hope. Hope that someday, in some way, our restless souls will bring heaven and earth together, and God will wipe away every tear. That adversity can breed unity, that hatred can give way to love." And in John Lewis's final written words, he insisted, "You have to believe that. You have to believe that." And I do. I believe that with all I am. And so may we put feet to our beliefs and to our prayers. And together in the grace of God, may we rise from this moment to live out the true meaning of our creed. Friends, join me in praying. God of all people, nations, races, we come to you in fervent prayer. Prayer for peace, prayer for justice, for righteousness, and for your healing and reconciliation and unity that follows after. We pray for our nation, for the coming inauguration and administration, and for all those charged as servants of our nation and its people. We pray for those across dividing lines, for understanding, for compassion, for healing, for growth. And we pray in confession for the lingering sins of racism, hatred, bitterness, falsehood, and division. for the ways that we have been silent or complicit or complacent for too long. But we ask now that your grace might transform us, heal us, and lead us on, that we might have persistence in the work of justice, that we might have hope for your will be done, and that we might have your love to lead us through together and find unity on the other side. May we believe that. May we live it, and may it be so. In the name of the Prince of Peace, the God of love, and the Spirit that transforms us and unites us. Amen.